Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share some hairstyles using fishtail braids. So let me know in the comment section which of the hairstyles is your favorite. Like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future uploads, and let's get started. For the first hairstyle, I'm going to start by parting my hair in a deep side part on the right side. So I'm going to divide off a small section of hair next to the part and split this into three smaller pieces. I'm going to begin a regular braid, crossing the two side strands once under the middle strand, and then I'm going to switch to a fishtail braid. So I'm combining the middle and the right strand together, so I have two sections for the braid. Now I'm going to divide off a small section from the right side and cross it under to the left. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from my head and cross it underneath to the left side as well. Then I'm going to divide off a small section from the left side and cross it under to the right. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from next to the braid and cross it under to the right side as well, incorporating it into the braid. And I'm going to repeat those steps, continuing the braid by dividing off small sections of hair from one side and crossing them under to the opposite side while incorporating new sections of hair into the braid. And I'm creating the braid down the left side of my head, right along the hairline. I want the braid to lay around the back of my head, so to make sure that happens without any bumps in the hair, I'm going to continue the braid down towards my left ear. Then once it reaches my ear, I'm going to stop incorporating sections of hair into the braid and just continue braiding the section in a regular fishtail braid. So I'm taking small sections of hair from one side and crossing it under to the opposite side, alternating between the left and right sections of hair. And once the braid reaches far enough down the section that I can pin it at the back of my head, I'm going to go back over the braid and just gently pull on small sections along the sides of the braid so they slide up and out. This will make the braid look wider, so I'm going to go up and down both sides of the braid, pulling on the hair so the braid is a lot wider and looks more full. Next, I'm going to bring the braid around the back of my head and lift up the hair at my crown. I'm going to divide off a small piece of hair from the back of my head and tie the braid to this section of hair. This will hold the braid in place securely without needing to use any bobby pins. And then I'm going to take a section of hair from my crown and twist this over the top of the braid. I'm going to pick up a second section of hair from behind my left ear and combine this with the previous section. And I'm going to tie the two sections together using a clear elastic band. And then I'm going to flip the ends of the section up and around the elastic so the two side sections are twisted. Then I'm going to divide off a new section of hair from the top right side of my head and bring this around to my left side. Then I'm going to divide off another section of hair from in front of the braid on the left side of my head and tie these two sections of hair together using another clear elastic band. And then I'm going to flip the ends up and around the elastic band so the two sides are twisted. And now I'm going to take the last section of hair from the right side of my head at the nape of my neck and bring this over the braid as well. I'm going to take another section of hair from the left side of the braid behind my ear again and tie these two pieces together using another clear elastic band. I'm going to flip the ends around the elastic band to make the two sides twisted again. And now I'm going to take the remaining hair and create a fishtail braid. So I'm dividing the hair into two equal sized sections, and I'm going to be crossing small sections of hair from one side underneath to the opposite side. So I'm taking a small piece from the left side and crossing it under and adding it into the right side. Then I'm dividing off a small piece from the right side section and crossing it underneath and adding it into the left side section of hair. And I'm going to repeat this pattern, crossing small sections of hair from one side underneath to the opposite side, working my way down the section of hair. And once the braid reaches far enough down, I'm going to go back over the sides of the braid and gently pull on the edges so small sections slide up and out of the braid just barely, and this will make the braid look a lot wider, so it'll appear to be a lot more full as well. And then to tie off the end of the braid, I'm just going to take a clear elastic band and wrap this over the bottom of the braid to hold it in place so it doesn't unravel. Today's video is sponsored by Native. They recently launched their new hair care range with lots of different scents to choose from. I chose the Citrus and Herbal Musk, which is a daily care shampoo and conditioner, and they provide a daily clean without stripping the hair of moisture. I like this one because I wanted a shampoo and conditioner that would help my hair feel hydrated while also leaving it smooth and looking shiny. I really enjoy using Native shampoo and conditioner, and since using it, I've noticed that my hair feels healthier and it's more moisturized. Native's shampoo and conditioner is made with only 10 ingredients. They're sulfate, dye, silicone, and paraben-free. Their products are also cruelty-free, which is something I really appreciate. And I also use the Almond and Shea Strengthening Mask. I really like the way this makes my hair feel. It nourishes strands and helps to replenish damaged hair by restoring moisture back into the hair. So make sure to try Native's new hair care range today. You can use my link and my code to get 20% off. That's shampoo and conditioner for only $14.40. And with my code, you can also get 20% off any deodorant or body wash. The next hairstyle is a Dutch fishtail style crown braid. So I'm going to be braiding my hair so it circles around my head. So with my hair parted in a deep side part, I'm going to pick up a slice of hair next to the hairline. I'm splitting the section into three smaller pieces, and then I'm crossing the right strand under the middle, and then the left strand under the middle. Now I'm going to combine the middle and right strand together and start taking small pieces from one side and cross them underneath to the opposite side. So I'm taking a small piece from the left side and crossing it under to the right. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair and cross it under to the right. Then I'm going to take a small section from the right side and I'm going to cross it underneath and add it into the right section. Then I'm going to pick up a new piece of hair and cross it underneath, adding it into the left section. And I'm going to repeat those steps, continuing the Dutch fishtail braid, working my way around my head. So I'm going to create the braid along the left side of my head, bringing in sections from along the hairline and from the top of my head. And as I'm braiding, I'm going to curve the braid around the back of my head. So I'm still crossing small sections from one side underneath to the opposite side, while incorporating new sections of hair into the braid from along both the nape of my neck and from the top of my head. As the braid gets closer to the right side of my head, I'm going to finish bringing in the rest of my hair. By bringing in the hair before the braid curves up the side of my head, this will help ensure that the hair that's pulled in isn't going upwards at an odd angle, so the hair will lay more cleanly against my head without any weird bumps in the hair. So once all of the hair from my head is combined into the braid, then I'm going to continue braiding the rest of the section in a fishtail braid. So I'm crossing small sections of hair from one side under to the opposite side until I've reached the end of this section of hair. And now I'm going to go back over the braid and pull out small sections so they loosen out of the braid. This will make the braid look wider and more full so it'll show up more easily. And then I'm going to lay the braid across the top of my head and pin it in place with bobby pins. So I'm going to push the braids through the middle of the braid and then slide them along my head so they line up with the braid. And they'll stay hidden underneath the hair this way, and also hold the braid in place really well. For the third hairstyle, I'm going to divide off a section of hair from the top of my head to use for my fishtail braid. I'm going to begin a regular three-strand braid, so I'm splitting the section into three smaller pieces. And I'm crossing the two side strands once over the middle strand to begin the braid. And then I'm combining the middle and right strand together to switch to a fishtail braid. I'm going to divide off a small section of hair from the right side and cross it over to the left side. And now I'm dividing off a small section of hair from the left side, crossing it over to the right, and then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from my head on the left side and cross it over the top, adding it into the right strand as well. I'm going to divide off a small section of hair from the right side and cross it over to the left side. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from my head along my hairline and cross it over the braid, adding it into the left strand. And now I'm dividing off a small section of hair from the left side, crossing it over to the right, and then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from my head on the left side and cross it over the top, adding it into the right strand as well. I'm going to divide off a small section of hair from the right side and cross it over to the left side. Then I'm going to pick up a new section of hair from my head along my hairline and cross it over the braid, adding it into the left strand. I'm going to continue these steps, crossing small sections of hair from one side over to the opposite side, while picking up and bringing in new sections of hair from my head. And since this is a half-up style, I'm going to continue bringing in hair until I've brought in sections from above both of my ears. And then I can stop incorporating sections into the braid once the braid reaches that point. And I'm just going to continue braiding the section a little further down in a regular fishtail style braid. So I'm taking small pieces from one side and crossing them over, adding them into the opposite section of hair. And I'm going to alternate this pattern between both the left and right side sections. And once the braid goes down the section far enough that I like the way it looks, I'm going to tie off the end of the braid. So I'm taking a clear elastic band and I'm going to wrap this over the bottom of the braid so it stays in place. And then I can go back and gently, pull on the sides of the braid to make it look wider and a little more full. That wraps up today's video. Let me know in the comment section which of the hairstyles was your favorite. Make sure to like and subscribe or click the thumbs down if you don't like videos like this. Either way, it helps me out. Make sure to subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future uploads, and I will see you next time.